You've done it, Ged. In these two treasures, you found what you sought, the means to save the world. You emerge from the cave expecting to find Ziggy Christ waiting to whisk you home in his triangular starship. But he's not there. And as you wait, the sky turning dark and three moons shining ever more brightly overhead, you realize he's not coming. You have to go to him, your soul tells you. And for a minute, you rage at the unfairness of it all. After the trials you've survived, all the terror you've faced down, now you're expected to travel what must be at least 150 miles of alien jungle again? Get a grip, Ged, your soul remonstrates. Be a grown-up. And you realize she's right. In the words of the great sage Bryan Adams, ain't no use in complaining, boy. You got a job to do. The treasures you've won won't do anybody any good if you're the only person who enjoys them. One way or the other, you must get home. If the only way to do that is to risk traveling this hellish, psychedelic, man-eating garden labyrinth again, well, that's what you're going to do. But you're not alone, Ged. You've got your soul, and your soul explains that you've also got the spirits of your ancestors with you too. The collective experience of all the stupendous badasses that fought the wilderness and survived and thrived so that you could someday enjoy the miracle of existence. 20,000 years ago, your direct progenitors took on this kind of challenge every day, like it was their job, because it was. If they didn't do it, they didn't eat, and more importantly, neither did their children. So dig deep, Ged. Put on your headphones and use the magic you've learned to reach out to your ancestors and ask them for help. They'll come through for you. And that feeling of setting off into the night jungle, senses razor sharp and heart full of terror and courage, that feeling of laying it all on the line because your people are depending on you to come through, it sounds an awful lot like this song.